Hey everyone, I'm Karsten, this is Dice Head Productions, and we have another Legend of the Five Rings clan breakdown video. We will be taking a look at the Crab Clan. We're going to break down this clan of bastions and builders, taking a look at each card from the core set and focusing on the themes that make Crab what it is. The Sacrificial Crab Clan defends the southern border of the Empire from the Shadowlands, and that is reflected in the way the clan plays as a whole. The major themes of Crab include powerful defensive cards, holding synergy, character sacrifice, and a form of taxation. But let's first take a look at the Crab Clan Stronghold and Champion. Shiro Nishiyama doesn't care if your characters are in a military or political conflict. It will give you a boost as long as you are the defender. This across-the-board bonus can make winning against a defending Crab player a chore, and the whopping +3 to your Stronghold province helps keep Crab in the game that much longer. Hida Kasada really tips the scale in the military direction with a whopping base power of 7, effectively outclassing nearly every other character's base military skill. His ability, in a way, helps fuel itself. Losing out on a pivotal action every conflict can really make it hard to win any conflicts at all. Note that this doesn't stop your opponent's reactions and interrupts. The Crab Clan mans the southern wall, and this really comes through in their strong defensive cards. Borderlands Defender has a strong stat line with an ability that protects it from some of the most popular forms of removal while defending. Defend the Wall is Crab's unique province, and it makes defending even sweeter, giving you the chance to use the ring activation against your opponent. Hiruma Ambusher surprises your opponent from your hand, removing a pesky character's abilities during a defense. Hiruma Yojimbo doesn't do anything to make your defense better except bring it substantial and aggressively costed stat line. The Mountain Does Not Fall and Reprieve both keep your defenders in the fight. The Mountain Does Not Fall causes a defender to continue standing their ground for the entire phase, while Reprieve keeps your characters on the board for one more turn. The Crab Clan are also builders, responsible for the powerful fortifications that keep the Empire safe. Kayu Shuichi and Shrew Yasuki only care that you have a holding somewhere on the table, grabbing fate and card advantage respectively. Hida Guardian can really help turn the tide of a conflict for you, giving a boost that is great even if you have only one holding in play. Rebuild is great for a lot of uses. Grabbing a holding to protect a key province is obvious, but if your champion is sitting in a broken province about to be discarded, you can save him and hope to draw him later on. Being the ones that stand against the Shadowlands, Crab believes a great deal in self-sacrifice and giving oneself to the greater good. Steadfast Witch Hunter and Stoic Gunzo are characters that require you to sacrifice others for powerful effects, a way to ready characters so that they can continue defending or give them additional strength. Funeral Pyre and Way of the Crab allow you to sack characters for additional utility in the forms of card draw and removal. Eager Scout and Caillou Envoy are both ideal sacrifice targets, one being free to play and the other gaining you additional advantage when it goes. Hida Tomonatsu and Vanguard Warrior require you to sacrifice them specifically, allowing you to remove a character after successfully defending or gaining some additional character advantage. Vengeful Berserker takes advantage of all of the sacrificing the previous cards have been doing. In game, the Crab Clan uses taxation to agitate opponents into continuing to attack them. Your opponent doesn't want to continue sending characters into your impenetrable defenses? Make them pay for that with honor, thanks to intimidating Hida. Jay Tetsubo not only serves as a great military attachment, but it also serves as a form of removal, essentially wasting your opponent's hard-earned fate. The idea of taxing your opponent doesn't get any more obvious than with Levy, taking your opponent's choice of one resource. Watch Commander gives a decent boost while taxing your opponent's honor for the right to play cards during conflicts. As a whole, the Crab Clan plays quite defensively, sacrificing their own characters for additional benefits while taxing their opponents for even more advantage. If you like the idea of holding out the storm to eventually exhaust your opponents into submission, Crab is for you. Thanks for watching this clan breakdown. Please like and subscribe for more Legend of the Five Rings clan breakdowns, decklists, and gameplay videos.